Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Moss, and welcome to this demo of real-time testing on the LambdaTest platform. Real-time testing allows you to perform live, interactive testing of your app or website on more than 3,000 browsers and operating systems. In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform real-time native mobile application testing using emulators and simulators that are hosted on the LambdaTest platform. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do is log into my LambdaTest account. And as you can see, I'm already logged in. So now that I'm logged in, I'm going to navigate to the left-hand side menu and expand it out. And then under the dashboard, I'm going to select real-time testing. After navigating to the real-time testing page, I'm going to select app testing. On the real-time app testing page, you can see this message, and it says you are testing on emulators and simulators. So this feature allows us to manually test our mobile application on both iOS and Android devices that are emulated or simulated on the LambdaTest platform. As you can see, I can select either an Android device or an iOS device. And once I've selected my target platform, my configuration options are updated. Then you can specify to either upload your mobile application from your local machine, or you can specify a source URL that LambdaTest will use to download the mobile application after the test session has started. Previously uploaded mobile applications will show up in the list here, and you can also filter this list based on the permissions of those uploaded mobile applications. After uploading a mobile application, it will be available in this list for 60 days. Once you've uploaded your mobile application or specified the source URL, you can then select the desired brand of device, and then the device itself and operating system version. And if I select iOS, you can see that we have similar options. We can select the device type, the specific device, and then an operating system version. For this example, I'm going to utilize the sample app APK that's provided by default. Now that we've selected our desired configuration, I'm going to start the session. After selecting start, LambdaTest creates a fresh device emulator matching my configuration settings. Once the test session is started, we can begin interactive manual testing of the mobile application. And in this example, we have a simple to-do app, so I can add new to-do items on this list. And then I can complete each item as well. And then on the left-hand side, you can see the control bar, which I can collapse or expand, and then I can also move it to any desired location on the screen. If we take a look at the first option in the control bar, you can see that we can install new mobile applications on this emulator. So similar to the configuration page, we can upload a new mobile application from our local machine, specify a source URL, or select a previously uploaded mobile application to install on this emulator. We can also kill our mobile app. And finally, we can also uninstall the application. One thing to note is that we can also perform browser-based testing of the web version of our application alongside our mobile application in the same test session. The next option in the control bar allows us to change the device that we're currently using. So here I can select Switch, and then I can select a different brand and device and start a fresh emulator. In addition, if I identify a bug while performing manual testing, I can select the Mark as Bug button. This will allow me to create a new screenshot of the device and a new issue. And using the options on the left-hand side menu, I can actually annotate the screenshot to highlight where the bugs are located. After adding the desired annotations, I can share the screenshot to specified email addresses or via a shareable link. I can also download the screenshot to my local machine or save this screenshot, which will make it accessible after the test session has ended via the test logs. We can also select the Mark as Bug button. This will prompt you to integrate with an external tool such as Jira, allowing you to create a new issue in the target tool. If you don't want to integrate with an external tool, you can still create an issue that exists in the LambdaTest issue tracker. Under the Mark as Bug button, I can select the video icon to begin recording this session. When I'm finished recording, I can select the button again to stop the recording. Once the video has been processed, it will appear in the gallery. The gallery is where screenshots and videos that you've taken in the current test session are stored. And from the gallery, you can select the down arrow to download screenshots and videos to your local machine. Below the gallery, we can start DevTools. DevTools allows us to access device logs, network logs, and app logs. We can also specify the level of logging as well. And under DevTools, we have device controls. In device controls, we can do things like change the language of the keyboard. We can also select rotate to change the device orientation. In addition, we can change the volume, put the device to sleep, and finally, we can activate the shake gesture, which will simulate shaking the device. Under device controls, we can also update the IP geolocation of the device. Under the settings menu, we have several options. The first option allows us to select an idle timeout limit for this test session. Currently, I've selected the idle timeout limit to be 60 minutes, but by default, it's set to 5 minutes. We can also associate this test session with a project, which is a way to organize your screenshots, recordings, and issues that are created from a test session. You can also specify the version of the project that you would like this test session to be associated with. We then have the option to perform network throttling, which will allow us to test our mobile application in different network conditions. So from this menu, we can select different networks, and we can even select different bandwidths within the same network, such as slow 3G or fast 3G. However, if none of these options meet my requirement, I can also create a custom profile. I can give this network profile a name, and then I can specify the download speed, upload speed, and latency of this custom network profile. One thing that's important to note is that if your mobile application has media which is playing audio, you will be able to hear that audio in the test session. Once you've completed your testing, you can select End Session to end the current test session. I'd also like to point out that the emulators and simulators that are being created by LambdaTest are not shared. Each time you create a new test session, a fresh emulator or simulator is being created, so you can be sure that you're working in a secure environment. After ending our test session, we can navigate to Test Logs to view the logs of our test session. Each of these log entries are associated with a test session, and you can see in the test log details that they are associated with a project. If any screenshot or video recording was taken during the test session, those will be accessible at the bottom of the test log. If we wanted to access any issues that were created during our test session, then we could navigate to the issue tracker. From here, we can view, share, and update any issues that we created during a test session. That wraps up real-time native mobile application testing on LambdaTest. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.